I was kind of nervous coming to this trip because a lot of the time when I am looking at a piece of nature, whether it's like a rock or maybe it's a body of water, I don't immediately jump to, oh, like, where did this come from? Or what is this? Sometimes I just look at it, I'm like, that's beautiful. And I'm like, why do I need to think quantitatively when this is like beautiful to begin with? But then you get past this threshold where you're actually excited to know where things come from. Now, that's not taking away from my appreciation of the landscape. It's like vastly improving it.
We're in a glacial lagoon where there's like a glacier over there calving and making all these icebergs that are floating around. But glaciers, I've learned about in class, but had never, it wasn't a lab class because there's no glaciers hanging around Maine. So this is like my first time like being able to like apply that knowledge to the field, and so it's really cool to be finally able to experience it.
We could go out there and say, oh, look at this inflation feature, isn't this cool? And now we're gonna go see this, and this is what this is, and this is what this is, and a more of a show and tell approach. But I don't think that empowers us all to be able to go forward and make our own interpretations.
Because we're at Bowdoin, we're able to have those resources to go out and do field research and really learn and study a topic more than I've ever experienced.
Reading a textbook is one thing, and I remember seeing the picture of a glacier like this, but actually looking at it and being there and being in the moment and taking so many classes on climate change and actually standing in a place where climate change was actually happening just meant so much.
There's definitely so many environmental issues that need to be solved, and I think collaboration is huge. I know that I've learned so much from all of the other students on this trip, and it just shows you that when you're trying to approach a problem, it's really important, especially in the sciences, to have many different perspectives and many different backgrounds. You need to kind of have an open mind when you kind of approach these issues, because not only are they complex to understand, but they're continually like changing. So I think having this kind of like adaptive mindset and just open mind, willingness to learn and kind of glean bits of information from different fields, whether it's like within the sciences or things we learn from our liberal arts education, I think that's really invaluable.
I think the connection to place that we're gaining through this experience is really important, because we're now like more connected to the earth, and that's going to make us more likely to try and save the earth